There's a brand new aviation museum that just opened up in the 608.
This is really cool. Josh Breiter's been there all morning. He's in Broadhead with the story. Looking the part this morning, Josh. Love the goggles.
Aren't these super cool? Yeah, we've got this on, and it's the moment we've been waiting for all morning. We're going to get inside this plane right here behind me, and Ami Eckerd Lee is going to be walking us through it. And this is pretty cool because, I mean, it's a tight space, and it really takes a little bit of effort to get in there, right?
Yes, it's not something you can just strap yourself in like a car.
A little different.
It's a whole process. It took me a few tries to figure it out. So, in order to get into the plane, you do have to hike yourself up there, and something to watch out for is that the airplane is constructed of a metal and wood frame and then fabric stretched over it and then painted with nitrate dope. So if you stepped on this, it's like a drum. You would go right through.
Right through it.
Over here, you can see there's a tread, and it's reinforced with wood underneath there. And then you can see what you're supposed to do with that. Don't grab onto the windshield because that's fragile, but go ahead and feel free to grab onto the front cockpit there.
All right.
Fun fact.
We're doing it.
You're the pilot now.
I'm the pilot.
Because the pilot always sits in the back, so.
And why do you sit in the back?
It's a little hard to explain, but basically, as you can see, you're behind the wing. The balance point of the airplane, like the center of balance, is under the wing. So if you were in the cockpit, or if you aren't, it's going to change how heavy the tail is. If you have a passenger in the front, it's not, because that's right under the balance point. So you have to be the constant there, and then the passenger is optional.
So I'm in. It's low, too. It's a lot lower than I expected.
That is partially because now you're protected from the wind and everything.
That makes sense.
And the visibility straightforward is not good, is it?
No, you can't see anything.
So if you're on the ground, you know, you kind of got to, if you can, crane your neck around the side. And then once you're in the air, you don't have to see straightforward so much as everything around you.
So it's more like being able to see the ground and stuff like
that. Yeah, and the air and sideways and... And also you tip forward a little bit once you're in flight.
I would hope so. So what are some of these levers in here?
Okay, so you'll find the stick that sits between your knees. That controls the elevators, which are these flaps here on the tail. That will tip the front of the airplane up or down.
Okay.
And then if you go side to side with it, that controls the ailerons on the wings, which...
Oh, look at that.
...will turn the... Well, I guess
all with this, just one, like, kind of a joystick in between my legs, yeah.
And it's connected. It's all manual. It's connected with wires that run from there, you know. And then the foot pedals control the rudder, which, like a boat.
Oh, there we go.
Is directly behind you. And
so there's a lot to do at one time.
Yes. Your hands are completely full. And then if you're flying, you'll find there's, like, a throttle, and you have to, you know, keep your hand on that most of the time. So... It would be handy to have extra arms and hands. And then you're wearing the helmet and the goggles, and those are for a practical reason, not just fashion. Obviously, the helmet will protect your hearing a little. There were no other hearing protectors then, and also your hair and the wind, and it's cold. But the goggles are so wind won't get in your eyes, but also oil, because the engines do leak oil. So, you know.
A little bit of everything there.
Yeah.
So this is pretty cool. One thing that you can check out here at the Kelch Aviation Museum, but you guys have a lot of stuff that people can check out for free.
Oh, absolutely. And we do have often events. You know, you can come in on a weekend. There'll be things for kids to do. There's always something going on. Like, there's always somebody messing around with an airplane or working on it. It's very much a living museum. So expect to see something new and weird every day out here.
Well, we like that. We love that. I mean, thank you so much for letting me get in this. This is so cool.
You're welcome.
Thank Guys, you we'll send it back to you in the studio. Of course, we'll have all this up on channel3000.com. But I think I'm going to fly myself to Kansas City this morning. That sounds pretty good to me. How about, are you going to hop in on me with me?
Get this gentleman a handful of balloons stat. He belongs in the movie Up.
I know. Doesn't he look like the
cute?
Kid from Up?
I love it. Oh. Little Boy Scouts costume, too.
Look at those goggles.
Josh Breiter this morning, making our day. Thank you, Josh.
Remember to let Josh know what inspires you in the 608. Reach out on social media or email him at inthe608@wisctv.com.